Strauss, in honor of the archetypical coquettish parlor maid, the soubrette.
Got it. Oh. Oh, that's the piece for the great-granddaughter of Joseph Strauss.
Now, if that's the same music as this, then I have to erase one.
Slightly faster tempo, but otherwise the same.
It's the same music, huh?
Yes. Just played slightly faster, maybe by a different orchestra.
Too bad, I have to erase the one I just recorded. Now it even stops when it's going on high speed.
On fast forward.
Yeah, I think it used to do that.
Hmm.
So that one is right, and this one has to be erased.
Hmm.
I mean, I have to record over it.
Yeah.
Spent all that time writing it up. I thought it was a new piece for me. It's not. Now you may turn on. I'm not listening.
Okay, let's see here.
The celebrations here in Vienna are almost over, except for an incomparable march by the elder Johann Strauss, composed in honor of Field Marshal Joseph Wenzel Count Kadetsky de Reditz. Italians tried unsuccessfully to shake off Austria's supremacy. Kadetsky won a decisive battle of the war, preserving Austria's empire. Is that the reason why today's audiences cheer the first bars of the Radetzky March? Certainly not. Radetzky's name would merely have landed in the history books.
He talks a lot more, yeah.
Well, that was Walter Cronkite.
His music raised the hero of his time to immortality. This is Walter Cronkite in Vienna, wishing you a happy new year.
That was 1987.
Yep.
January 1st, 87.
Yep. Now look, they have this
new year in the area.
So you might look. They had these words, "Prosit." I guess that's in Dutch or something.
Oh, "Prosit New Year." Yeah, that's German.
Oh, German.
Prost. Prost is health.
Oh, health. Okay.
They raise a drink and they say Prost.
I see.
Prost.
Hey, what's going on here? You have. What
have
are you?
To erase. I had recorded it today. But I already have it, so I have to erase it.
Oh, I see.
That's the problem.
What are you going to record over it with?
I'll have to sometime.
Oh, so it's going to go into the stack there.
Yeah, I have to go in there to wait for another.
How many do you have?
I reduced a few of them today.
Okay.
Too bad. You know, I thought I had completed a tape by recording that, and then turned out I have it.
Yep.
But I don't want doubles, so.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, what is this? Of work.
1001, 1010. Okay.
This was tape 1002.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's on tape 1002. This is 972.
I see.
972 album.
Down from there. Oh, updating the index, huh?
Oh, I have to.
I see. The unreadable index.
Oh, I can read.
Yeah.
Just very important to have opus numbers. That way you can distinguish.
Oh, yeah.
Otherwise.
Otherwise you have all sorts of numbers. Kirkel and D
well,
and
A number.
F.
What I mean is you have to have A number, not just a title. because there's something called gossip. Mm-hmm. Gossipers and the this one. What was this one called?
Hmm? This march?
Schwetzerin.
What's the Schwetzerin? Schwetzerin. Chatterbox.
So, gossipers and chatterbox. I was confusing it. It's different things.
Oh, those are two different numbering systems.
Right. No, it's just two different pieces.
Pieces, okay.
So I thought that I had recorded previously chatterboxes. Mm-hmm. I mean, gossipers, and then I was getting chatterboxes today. It's not true.
I see.
Huh. What a confusion.
Yeah. Different people get to hear it.
Oh yeah, generations change.
Like when did he die? Herbert von Karajan.
That's strange. I had it all figured out exactly where I wanted it.
Hmm.
So it's very strange. Oh, it's at a different place now. Huh. I don't understand that. On the recorder up there, I had exactly. This thing here is different. This part's different from all the rest.
Yes.
So I was watching the position of this thing, and I had it all figured out. I had to be there.
Mm-hmm.
But that's going to cut off.
Really?
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
Now, that's coming at a different place than I had thought.
Well, the...
No, it had started there is the position I was supposed to record. But there's still music there, so I can't. All right, now I have to listen again. I have to find out where he starts speaking. So it looks like it's down at the bottom. Now it's going to be very hard to cut it off. But that talk, that talk is here now, and it was up there before. It's all half a turn phase differently here than upstairs. And I don't know why that is. There he's talking. So now I effectively have to do the work again. Here the one piece finishes and then he talks on a new. Now that.
Okay. So you want to get rid of his voice.
I want to get rid of the voice and that one drum thing.
And the one drum, but not the second drum.
That's right. It's very hard. That's why I said this is very
so
tricky.
So you must count exactly where...
Well, I want to find the position of that white thing.
White thing.
There he was talking at that point.
Sorry.
That was too much. It's very hard to do. Sometimes you erase something you don't want to erase.
Okay.
See, he starts talking right there, but the music is also right there. So if you erase
his voice,
there, I'll get
erase
some of the
music.
That's it. So I will. I know. I pretty much how to do this. I'd rather not erase music. I'd rather have some voice left. So let me that position.
Yeah,
see
because
what happens.
If we were to digitize this years later, we could remove it with microscopic accuracy.
All right, now. It's very tricky. I'm going to do about 3/4 of a turn. Often when you put it in, it shoots it back a little bit from where it was.
We're
all right, now.
Good luck.
I'm going to stop there, see if it has gotten that first drum beat out already, because sometimes it seems to record ahead. Now let's see what it sounded like back here. Didn't get it much, did I? I did get the first drum beat off, so...
Mm-hmm.
So to stop there was a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
But here, it didn't take anything away of his voice, did it?
No.
So that part is good. The end. The end is good.
Mm-hmm.
Have to stop it there. Now starting should start back a little bit more.
Yes.
Right there. Oh, see, it shot it back too far. Well, let's try it there. It's a little farther back than I had wanted, but let's try it there and around to the other place again. Now, let's see if that has done it. If not, sometimes I get too impatient, just forget about it. That's better. That's better.
All right.
I didn't
then.
Cut any music. Yep, four.
All right.
I watch it go back this way, too.
Mm-hmm.
Five, four. Three, two, this is very technical, the most difficult part I ever do. One,
yeah.
And there should be the zero time.
Mm-hmm.
So there's where I should start. But then what I do is go back one more
to
get ready for that.
Mm-hmm.
To reconfirm, sort of.
Yep. This is the one-of-a-kind work.
So, yeah, I had to go back to see exactly.
Yep.
Now, there's where I'm going to start.
Yep.
And then I'm going to run once more.
Yep.
Whoa! See, now I'm not sure. It seemed like there was more sound there.
Well, the little red thing went by too fast.
Yeah, there was more sound than I thought. So I don't want to start erasing too early. I would like to erase the clapping, but it's not a real big problem, clapping. You don't want to erase the sound, if you can help it.
Right.
Oh, no, that was a different sound.
Oh, whoops.
That was from another recording. So that I can erase.
Okay, so to the basement, the downstairs studio to complete the erasure. The erasure procedure.
Oh, I can't see.
Oh, whoops.
I need the flashlight.
Oh, whoops, okay.
Oh.
Good luck. One, two. Oh, good.
I hope so.
All right.
I think it's good.
Uh-huh.
Let's go back in a little bit more.
Success.
Very much so, yeah.
Yep, all right. Mission
now,
accomplished.
How do I do this? Put this back here.
Yep.
Follows the note that's connected to his talk. His syllable is connected with a note. And then there's another note that I think is the beginning of the piece. I don't think that the beginning of the piece is the note that's connected to his syllable. But maybe you could help me understand that. This was announced for a previous thing that I erase, and I should have, you know, erased it well. Didn't get his voice out. So just listen and see what you think. Ready?
Yeah.
Now that is that the first note of the piece?
I have to turn down the other thing. Are you playing it again?
I will. when it says du, 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 if those are the first notes of the piece.
So you mean the note that's under his voice? Whether that's...
It's not a part of the piece, I think.
No,
that's what
I think it is.
Oh, you think it is. That's going to be very hard to erase.
Go back. No, you can't erase. Well, hold on. Well, you could erase. Hold on. Let me see.
Listen again.
Okay, I'll tell you what happened. So you know how there's a gap between the erase head and the record head?
Mm-hmm.
So... the guy's voice was just to the right of the erase head,
mm-hmm. So
it didn't get erased, mm-hmm. But the new thing got recorded on top of it.
Mm-hmm.
So in other words, you can't separate them. They're combined.
Mm-hmm.
Unless you want to just simply, you know, cut off the first note a little bit, but... You know.
But you think that behind his voice is the first note. Now, a better way to do this would be look for the work on YouTube. See how it plays on YouTube. See what the first note is.
If YouTube has it.
Yeah, it's a very obscure word, right?
Yeah, YouTube, there's a lot YouTube doesn't have.
So you think that the first note is right there at his
yeah.
voice. Uh-huh.
Well, you know what? What I also hear is that the note under his voice is off key.
It's off key, very bad.
Why? Because the pitch had not settled yet on your recording machine. So it wouldn't really hurt to get rid of his voice because you're going to get rid of an off pitch note anyway, and it would sound more correct to not have the off pitch note.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But still, you're missing a note of the piece.
I
would like to see if I can find it on YouTube.
All right. So in another. 40
oh, no,
some
no,
minutes. Okay. Let me see if I can get a close up of this. Whatever you need to do.
Timing what I have to erase. I have to erase this part.
Uh-oh.
I have to erase it.
Sound like the sliding off the head.
It's a bad recording too, but it's recorded on sharp.
Oh, no, it was a bad recording.
This is also...
Anything recorded on the sharp after 1990-something is not good because
mm-hmm.
it got repaired and that settings changed.
Sorry, you're still taking a picture.
No, it's okay. You get a lot of material, you cut out what you don't need.
Yeah.
That's the principle.
I should be listening to this.
Sure, yeah.
Death and Transfiguration.
Yep.
Richard Strauss. Stuff to get rid of.
Yeah. Hold it in place. Watch it with your hold it with one hand.
I know how to do it. Just very short. Just that one half syllable utterance.
Yeah.
I have to get rid of it. Didn't get rid of it, my goodness. Start earlier, that's all. It's hard to get rid of stuff sometimes.
At least you have good light.
That might not be enough. It's when sometimes when you put it the tape in, it goes farther in than you want. Oh, I guess it is, yeah. Yeah, I guess it is. I was looking at the wrong side.
Gotta do it again, huh?
Yeah. It's really, really tricky, actually.
Usually you get it on one fell swoop.
I usually do. See, what happens is when you put the cassette in, it moves it ahead a little bit, and that's... it moves it ahead, too far ahead. Yeah.
You moved it further ahead.
Well, I want it down here. I don't want it to go up farther. If it goes up too far,
You moved it forward in time, you know, by turning it.
See? It goes forward.
You just moved it forward in time with your finger. To move it backward. See, now you just moved it backward in time.
I want it here. Now you moved it forward. I want it to stay there, right there. See, it goes up, so far up.
Well, you can turn it. Okay, you can turn the thing. Look. What do you want where?
I want it back a little bit to the bottom.
Okay, then you can just turn it with your finger.
Oh, okay. Okay, I didn't realize.
Did you try that? Turn the spindle with your finger.
That's fine. Okay, good.
No. It has to be against to get the best, you know.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. I think that should have it. I didn't know you could turn it when it was there.
Well, I don't think these machines have brakes on their spindles.
Got it that time.
Got it. All right. Mission accomplished.
Yeah.
Another editing job performed on compact cassette.
Special music for Easter.
Yep.
So it's happened that you pulled out that very cassette that I had that story about.
Yeah.
I've heard this piece with other music.
The
text.
Yeah. Oh, I just picked various cassettes that looked a little different from different periods. One was in the 80s, one the 90s, and that one was a piece of the index.
My, so much work.
Yeah.
Oh.
That reminds me of what they have in archives.
So much
work,
Jerome. Look at that. That's a lot of work, you think of it.
Well, that's just one card.
Backup disc. Okay, yeah.
Yep.
Oh my goodness. Yeah, oh my goodness. Oh, you have me putting that on.
Yeah, it's maintenance. And of course, doing a little editing there. That's the last one. That's 40 of 40.
Oh wow, I've seen 40 already.
In the corner, it says 40 to 40.
Okay. Interesting, thank you. Close.
Yep.
Very interesting.
I'll put that full screen there, so that's a little...
And if I want to hear what's playing now, just go radio.
Just go to radio.
How do I make it play?
Well, in the corner it says listen live. Click play. I don't even know what that is.
No, I don't either.
Don't recognize it.
But it's one that will be announced at the end, huh?
Yeah. Could be A Midsummer Night's Dream. Yeah, it's Midsummer Night's Dream. There you go. Okay.
That's probably it. Next work. The last work.